point, line, square, cube, hypercube, and cube. As the dimension changes, the shapes change with it. And number systems evolve with dimension. Real numbers live in one dimension. Complex numbers in two, quaternions in four, octonions in eight. But isn't that strange? Shapes exist in every dimension. So, why do numbers exist only in dimensions 1, 2, 4, and 8? Why not in 3, 5, or 9? These four systems are created by combining real numbers with imaginary units. Mathematicians actually recognize only these four as true number systems. The reason is simple and clear. Numbers must support one more essential feature. That feature is the operations. Numbers form a world where operations have to behave consistently. So, if you want a number system in any dimension, operations like addition and multiplication must work without contradictions. To make that happen, three essential operations-related rules must hold. Number one, closure, which means that when you perform an operation, the result must stay inside the system. Number two, the associative law. Without this rule, you couldn't group parts of an expression or break them apart. Number three, the distributive law. This rule connects two completely different operations, addition and multiplication, and makes them work together without conflict. There are other useful properties too, identities, inverses, the commutative law. But these are not required for a system to qualify as a number system. Quaternions and octonions break the commutative law of multiplication, but they are still accepted as legitimate number systems. Now, you can probably guess why number systems exist only in dimensions 1, 2, 4, and 8. In every other dimension, these essential operation rules are not all satisfied. Let's look at a concrete example. What goes wrong in 5 dimensions? For the case of 3 dimensions, please watch the related video. To build a 5-dimensional number, you need one real part and 4 distinct imaginary units. Each imaginary unit is assumed to square to minus 1. The crucial challenge is this: the multiplication operations between 2 different imaginary units. You must define these operations in order to define multiplication at all. Let's try the most natural approach. E1 times E2 equals E3. E2 times E3 equals E4. E3 times E4 equals E1. So far, so good. We'll now use these conditions to determine the value of E3. Along the way, we will see that a contradiction inevitably appears. First, take this equation. Multiply both sides by E3, assuming the associative law. We get E3 times E1 equals minus E4. Next, take this equation again. Multiply both sides by E1. We get E1 times E4 equals minus 1. So far, we've derived these relations, right? Now, take this equation once more. Multiply both sides by E4. E3 times minus 1 equals E1 times E4. But we already showed that E1 times E4 equals minus 1. Therefore, E3 equals 1. Since E3 is supposed to be an imaginary unit, not a real number, this is a contradiction. The multiplication collapses into inconsistency. This result isn't just because of this particular choice. No matter how you define these operations, whether you try plus 1, minus 1, another imaginary unit, or the general form of 5D number, the contradiction will appear somewhere else. That's why a consistent number system can't exist in 5 dimensions. The same kind of contradictions happen in dimensions 3 and 7 as well. However, in the dimensions 1, 2, 4, and 8, addition and multiplication are well defined, just as they are in the real numbers. They satisfy the essential requirements for forming a number system. But there is an interesting twist. In eight dimensions, with the octonions, the associative law actually fails. Even so, the octonions preserve one crucial property. Multiplying two numbers never changes their length. This is a special stability of the multiplication operation, often described as a norm-preserving algebraic structure. This property holds only in dimensions 1, 2, 4, and 8. In other dimensions, even this stability breaks down. This is called Hurwitz Theorem. Shapes exist in every dimension, but numbers do not. This is where the symmetry between shapes and numbers breaks apart. Did you enjoy this math traveling? Don't forget to like and subscribe for the next. Thank you.